Hello, everyone. I am Ben Johnson, the host of the Perpetual Chess Podcast, and more importantly, this very podcast, How to Chess, brought to you by Chessable. And this week, we feature a special guest. He is GM Davorin Kolyasevich, a grandmaster, author, trainer. He wrote two acclaimed and popular books, Beyond Material, which is now available on Chessable, and his new book, How to Study Chess on Your Own, Creating a Plan that Works and Sticking to It. It's drawing rave reviews. There's tons of actionable study plans and discussion of how to approach chess study in it. So I definitely recommend that book. And Davorin is joining us today in order to answer our first listener question. So at Mr. Jim Jones 71 chimed in on Twitter. And if you have a question to ask, by the way, feel free to email howtochess@chessable.com or hit us up on social media. We are happy to help out with any chess study question or sort of study management question that you may have. So Jim's question was, how do you go over Grandmaster games? Now, obviously, everyone's told to go over games. We know it's a good thing, but there are lots in the details that can be tricky. So we've got a few questions to break that down further. But first, let's welcome Davorin to the show. Davorin, thanks for helping out here.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Okay, so we are going to dive into, I've broken Jim's question down into some components that I think will be helpful to myself and to our viewers and listeners. Davorin, are you ready to dive in?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, let's do it. So question number one, Davorin, is how much time to spend when analyzing a game? So let's say you have 90 minutes to look at chess games on a given day. Is it better to look at six games quickly, or is it better to look at one game in depth?
For me, it would be one game in depth. Or let's say prefer depth over going over more games, because the nature of this kind of study is that you want to understand the game well, right? So if you go kind of superficially over many games, you might miss important things, like, you know, how this grandmaster made the decision, which candidate moves he considered, what was important in the position for him. And if you do it for, let's say, one or two games within those 90 minutes, I think you can pick up these things much more effectively than if you do it, kind of superficially.
Okay, good advice. Now, Davorin, I think that the problem that a lot of people run into is that you might be reading an annotated book, but even in an annotated book, unless they explain every move, there are going to be moves you don't understand. So what do you advise if a club player is looking at a game and just there's a series of moves or a single move that they just have no idea why it was played? How can they try to figure it out? Because obviously that's where the learning takes place.
Yeah, exactly. That's a good point. It's a good thing if you don't understand something, because it means you will learn something. Now, you can do it if you analyze it a little bit on your own. Maybe something will come up, some idea. Maybe if you go through the game, like for the next 5 or 10 moves, or you see the whole game, and then later you see maybe why this player played this move. Maybe it's not obvious immediately, but as you play a couple of more moves, then it becomes clear. But if you really cannot figure it out from the annotations or on your own, the last resort, of course, is the engine. But I would really use the engine in this kind of study as the last thing. But if you use your mind, even if you try to figure it out on your own, but you do not manage to, you still have, you know, the thought process was there, yeah? So you will still learn something from it.
Yeah, that's good advice. And of course, the engine does play into this, but that's something I'd like to talk about more. But there's also these situations where it's not like an engine answer. You know, it might be like a prophylactic move where you're trying to prevent your opponent's plan, or a more closed position where engines are better than they've ever been in terms of providing insight about what they're doing. But there still can often be that feeling like, what is this move all about? So do you have any guidelines for how long? Like you say, okay, maybe 45 minutes per game if we're going to do two games in 90 minutes, and we're just totally flummoxed by a move. We just don't understand what on earth is this pawn to h3 move. What is it preventing? So how long should we spend trying to figure it out before we get to the rest of the game?
No, a couple of minutes. I mean, you shouldn't, unless it's some combination or something, just a couple of minutes to try to figure it out on your own. And then check with the annotations and move on, I would say. Because, you know, even in those games, strong players have not maybe played the best moves. You know, it could be some move that's, as they say, toilet move. You know, you play a move, you get rid of it, you go, and you go for a walk. You don't have to figure out every single move. As long as you know what the main ideas were in different stages of the game, I think it's fine.
Okay, and obviously if it's a more tactical position, if things are flying around, then the engine is just going to be spot on in terms of, you can always make a sort of like dummy move. Like, in fact, if you're using a program like Chessbase, you can hit the key X and it'll show you what the other side will do if it's their move. I think a lot of people are using tools like Chess24's analysis or Lee Chess or something like that. And for those, you can just find the most move your king over one square or move a rook pawn one move. And then it'll tell you what the opponent's next move will be. And sometimes that's helpful as well. But I think that Davorin's point of not torturing yourself is also important. And Davorin, you know, this is a quick hitting show, but I still would love to hear what was your own experience with learning from Grandmaster games?
It was different at different stages, I would say. When I was starting out, I mostly read books with collections of games of Alekhine and Kasparov, Karpov, and all of these players from the past. These days, I like to look at games of contemporary grandmasters because, modern chess is slightly different than the chess from the past, obviously. But I would say when I was younger, when I learned the most, my main goal was, as I said before, to try to understand why they made decisions that they made. I think this is the key, in my opinion. This should be the main goal when you're going over these games. Not to particularly learn strategy per se, because I think you learn a lot of things. You learn about openings and endgames and strategy and tactics. You can learn about everything when you go through a game. But simply to try to understand their thought process. And this helps you, maybe not after, one or two sessions, maybe not after 10, but over time, I think it helps you to pick up these patterns, you know, how these strong players think.
Okay, great advice. So stick with it, even if you feel like, you look through a game and you feel like I didn't necessarily learn something, stick with it. And, you know, the lessons may be being absorbed on a subconscious level. And I know that there's lots of strong players who've said that, you know, they just go through reams of games. And if it doesn't make sense at first, sooner or later it does. And my last big question for you, Davorin, is how is it different when it's your own game? Everyone says, analyze your games. Now, is that the same sort of treatment? I mean, obviously, one would have a bit more of a window into why the moves were played, at least for your own side. But how would you adapt that advice for analyzing one's own games?
No, I think it's different. At least the goals are different in a way, because when you analyze your own games, the main idea is to try to understand where you made mistakes, at least in my view, and then try to improve these mistakes as you go on. But when you analyze games of other players, you want to pick up the good things, so that you can incorporate them into your own game. But when it comes to analyzing the pure chess content of your own game or a game of a master game, I think the process is very similar. You want to get into the depth, right, to understand the position as well as you can. So there are some similarities, some differences. But overall, I think both practices are very important to improve as a chess player.
Okay, yeah. And what about engine use when going over your own games? How should one approach that?
I actually did explain this in my recent book, How to Study Chess on Your Own. Probably it should come as the last thing, as a check of your own analysis of your own games. But sometimes you can use it while you analyze. If you're an experienced analyst, you can use the engine while you analyze because it's a bit quicker. And you just have to make sure that it doesn't interfere with your own thought process.
So Davorin, of course, Chessable is known for its space repetition, proprietary move trainer technology. Now, as I think about going over games, one thing I wonder is it a good idea to review a game multiple times? Like if you see a game that really makes an impression, is it good to come back and look at it later or just plow through them and keep going.
Absolutely, yeah. Especially if you see a game that could be like a model game for something that really impressed you, you can review it, like, let's say, maybe in a couple of days or then in a couple of weeks. And this reminds me, you know, when I was younger, I used to reread my books, like with these master games, because there were no many good books, yeah? So I just had to reread them. But I did sort of a spaced repetition because I was going back to my old, you know, favorite games. And that way, I think it helped me reinforce these learnings and remember these games better.
Good stuff. And of course, by model games, Davern means like if you're, say, you're trying to learn the King's Indian, so you're looking at a bunch of Gligorich or Kasparov games or something like that, you find a game that you find particularly instructive about the way they handled the opening, and then you say, okay, you know, I study a lot of games, but I'm going to really study that one. I'm going to study that one multiple times, which calls to mind one other question, Davern. Should we target games from the openings we play, or is it better to read sort of a big tome with a wide variety of games like Alekhine's Collected Games or Zurich 1953 or something like that?
No, definitely there is a benefit to this approach that you study the games from your own openings that you play. But I think when it comes to master games, you have to see the variety of ideas, openings, playing styles. I think that's the greatest benefit you will get from such games.
Okay, so do look at games from your openings, but not only games from your openings.
Yes.
So, Davern, we are out of time, but those were some amazing insights. I hope that Jim Jones and everyone watching and listening learned as much as I did about sort of the proper way to analyze both Grandmaster games when you're trying to learn from the masters and their own games. Thank you, Davern, for your insights.
Thanks. It was a pleasure.
And as always here on How to Chess, I'd like to share three bullet points, three takeaways that I learned from this quick hitting but informative conversation with Grandmaster Davern Kolyasevich. So number one is when you're analyzing games, you want to emphasize depth over breadth. Just look at a couple games in detail. That's going to be more helpful than just flying through games. So as we discussed, if you're doing 90 minutes a day, 45 minutes on two games would be great. But obviously, the more time you have, the deeper you can dig. Number two is the engine should be used as a last resort. Of course, it's a great tool and we're glad to have it, but you want to try to generate your own thought processes because that's what's ultimately going to make you a better player. But ultimately, if you're stumped, we've only got 45 minutes for a given game, it's okay to turn on the engine and try to figure it out from there. And point number three, I thought was super insightful about reviewing the games, especially us adults with lots going on in our lives, we're not necessarily going to remember the finer points of every game that we review. So it's important to come back to the games. That can be particularly useful for model games, as Davern said. So always good to utilize spaced repetition and come back and make sure that you are absorbing all that there is from a given instructive game. So thanks for tuning in to How to Chess, everyone, and we will catch you all next time.